The development of G-Power robots, we have done it like that. This is our G-Power robot, and you are watching that this is a unique concept. We took two eating bowls, one this bowl and second is this bowl, and it is just like a normal you can use in the soup or other type of food stuff you can use in. So we took these two bowls, we connect it from the bottom like here these are two bowls are connected, and with these screws you can see this is the guide rail for the counterweight. You can see this wire is the it is for the left right movement, and we can use here with this stuff. This is the normal reeling wheels we put here. You can see this in a normal aluminium pipe, square aluminium pipe we take, and this will work like this, like this. So this will work accordingly on these directions. This is the it will move like this 180 degree. Yes. This robot concept is that this robot is totally based on the gravity. Now have a look on the operational side of this robot. This is the standard CD-ROM, CD disk, and we place this CD disk on a motor, and you can see that there is a motor here. Here is a motor, and here is the counterweight. We use two batteries and one Allen key bolt for the weight, and it will work like that, that when it will move, the thing will be same. The disc will be stationary. So the whole motor shaft power will transform on the body, and the body will move towards forward, like that. So this is the controller circuitry, here is, and it is basically a digital 4-channel receiver, and we can send the appropriate command for move forward, move reverse, move left, move right, and when we send the command to move forward, it will work like that, and we will when we will send the command to move back, it will run like that. But the disc will be the same, disc will be the stationary. And the second thing is, which is the most important, it is the balancing bar. This balancing bar, we use a normal balancing bar. It is a conventional bar we can use in the placement of the cassette players in the car, or cassette recorders in the car, radios. So this is the fitting. The people said that this is a fitting bar for the placing the radio sets in the vehicle. So as far as the movement is concerned, that this is the first concept we are working to develop it. We have so many options for this robot that it can run at the speed of 60 kilometers per hour. It has a braking ability. It can apply its brake at the 60 miles per hour, and it will stop within 10 meters. So So at this section we will place our rubber grippers on it, here and here, with the rubber grippers. Rubber grippers will give you more friction than any other conventional plastic metal material. The purpose is that this robot can also jump. So when it will move forward or reverse, at that point here, here, and here, there are three major fins which will work like this, 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 this. So it can quickly jump around 8 feet high, and here we will install the mechanical system, plungers and other type of things, so it can jump over a person from only 1 foot. If a person is standing here, so it can jump over it. So this is the right now the development phase. We are developing the whole soul theory. This is this weight we use for movement of left right turns, that it can turn like this, it can turn like this. So this weight will also stationary, a motor will install here, and when this will work like that or like that, this power will transform on this bar, and this bar will move this robot like this. On this bar, the motor will install here, connected with here, with the guide rails, and when we give it the command, it will run like that, or run like that. So this is the development phase. Right now we have fixed only one motion, and that is forward reverse. And as you can see, this is the total concept, and it will run like that. So the why it is G power, because it uses the gravitational power, it uses the gravitational force to hold this disc. The gravitational force will hold this disc due to this weight, weight number one, weight number two, weight number three. We have used two weights, the conventional 9 volt batteries, you can see here. One battery is here, and second battery is here. And all the G forces apply on these weights holds this disc for a longer period, and this works like that. So this is my new concept, the G power robots.